6:30 p.m. at the Italian Center on a thousand of 508-537-1443.
Yeah.
Number 44.
Yeah! twice in that last play. That's why he came back. Motion, so they call it back.
Pitch. Proud of you, kid.
Thank you.
he'd hit. Call for holding. It's about first and 30. Second team's in with 2:30. Thank you.
to represent the school as well as the football team has done by the way you behave in this assembly and the way you behave later today and at the game tomorrow, so that everyone continues to think of Lemonster High School the way we want them. and a young man who's had a fine season for us, a great kid and a great player, number four, Mark Burns. One of our starting wide receivers, number 14, Ryan Young. One of our defensive ends, number 23, Paul Bergeron. Let's go! A young man who did a great job for us down the Shrewsbury game. He ended up getting an injury, he broke his leg, and he was unfortunately out for the year, but he's been all of our practices on a 25-1. Fine job for us, number 41, Perry Fall. Number 61, Andrew Kelly. One of our defensive ends, and a very fine job for us, number 65, Scotty Duke. Wow. I'm a senior manager. I'd like to bring down the rest of that group. This is the group that's going to beat Fitchburg High tomorrow at Crockett Field. Will the rest of the team come on down, please? Thank you.
Michelle Revine. Bettina Charpentier. Gino Marchand.
Come on! Sunday's Super Bowl preview. The Central Massachusetts title games feature teams with plenty of bowl experience. In Division I, St. John's of Shrewsbury has been to the bowl four times, riding a three-game winning streak in 1977, 1985, and 1988, that last win coming over Saturday's opponent, Leominster. Speaking of Leominster, the Blue Devils will be making their ninth title appearance, sporting a 6-2 record, including a 12-3 victory over Westboro last year. St. John's, relying on a potent passing attack, compiled a 9-1 record on the season, with that only loss coming in a shocker at the hands of Algonquin. Leominster finished the year at 8-2, stumbling to Wachusett 14-13 and getting blown out by Brockton in week number 7. Now, despite those two games, the Blue Devils are dangerous. Mark Matthews, as seen here in the season opener against Weymouth, can throw a score on the board at any time. When these two teams met in 88, St. John's pulled out a 1-point win, 8-7. Expect another close one on Saturday. That game will get underway at 12:30 at WPI. North captured the Division III championship with a 13-point win over Narragansett, 27-14. North Middlesex will cross the North Bridge on their way to the Division II title, 20-0. And St. John's will neutralize Leominster with their potent passing attack, 27-20 for the Division I crown. In East
Shrewsbury, and Leominster was just too much to handle by St. John's. Here's the highlights. Mark Matthews will put Leominster on the scoreboard first. This 35-yard run down the right sideline, giving Leominster a 6-0 lead early in the first quarter. The point after was good, 7-0 Leominster. Just moments later, Don Chabon will pick off a pass, which will go on to set up another Leominster score.
He cuts in front right here. There you can see it. And
great interception by Chabon. That would lead to a 28-yard field goal and a 10-0 Leominster lead. It'll be Jim Clark from 28 yards out, right through the middle, and Leominster has its 10-0 lead in the first quarter. Now in the second quarter, St. John's will not only get on the scoreboard, it'll also put itself in the record book. Brian Hunt gets all of this 44-yard field goal, eclipsing the old mark of 38 yards set by Bill Hollis at Plymouth Carver back in 1975. That one, fortunately for St. John's, would be their high water mark on the day. In the third quarter, Leominster would boost its lead to 17-3. The score set up on this Mark Wirinen to Don Chabon pass of 71 yards.
Finally brought
inside the 5, which would set up a 1-yard plunge for quarterback Mark Wirinen as he just gets in behind that front line offensive wall. And the quarterback sneak produces a 17-3 Leominster lead. Then in the fourth quarter, Mike Wallace will break free for the 77-yard touchdown run. Look at Wallace go, 77 yards for the score. The extra point is good, and Leominster moves to a 24-3 lead. That's the way the final score will read. Leominster 24, St. John's of Shrewsbury 3. Championship. And for Leominster, some revenge, as they lost to St. John's in 1988 in the Super Bowl game. 8-7 for Leominster, their ninth trip to the Super Bowl, their sixth win. And for St. John's, offense, the same old problem. Their fifth trip to the Super Bowl, they've scored a total of 45 points in those games, but they have won three of them. That's a look at the Central Mass games. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll take a look at the five title winners.